I'm still on the square, the Jackson County Square in Scottsboro, Alabama, and behind me you see a statue, and when I move out of the way you'll see the courthouse in the distance, the Jackson County Courthouse. But the statue you see behind me is a statue of General Andrew Jackson, the American whose this county was named after. And I'm going to step out of the way and tell you a little story about this statue. This statue was erected in 1976 in the American Revolution bicentennial year, which was 200 years, 1776 to 1976. And there's an encryption on the base of the statue that says General Andrew Jackson, soldier, statesman, 7th President of the United States. Jackson County was created by the state legislature on December 13, 1819, while in session in Huntsville, Alabama, which is about 40 miles to the west of where I'm standing. The county was named in honor of General Andrew Jackson, who was visiting in Huntsville at that time. This statue was presented by the citizens of Jackson County during the year of the bicentennial, 1776 to 1976. And you see the statue there. There's been quite a bit of controversy about the statue of General Jackson. Some say it is ugly. Some like it. Some don't. And it has kind of a concrete appearance, not a real attractive statue. But anyway, about 2 or 3 years after the statue was erected, some local teenagers decided that they would behead the statue. So they came up here at night and took something and knocked the head off, broke it off at the neck, off the statue of Andrew Jackson. So he was beheaded. We had a local dentist here at that time. His name was Dr. Ralph Shepherd, that had an office just off the square here. And he came over and looked at the statue, and all the people were saddened that vandalism had decapitated General Jackson. So he volunteered to repair the statue. And he said, I do root canals all the time, and I drill into teeth and work on porcelain structures. And he said, I think I can take my talents and reattach the head to the body of General Jackson. So our local dentist came up here with some good-sized tools, and he drilled a hole down into the neck of the statue, straight down into the body of the statue. He also drilled a hole up into the head of the statue, a good-sized hole, and he came up with a metal rod that would just fit that hole. So he took some cement and he inserted the pin into the base of the statue, put in the cement, inserted the head on top of the pin and correctly positioned it, and used his cement to repair the break area, the neck area. And so you see it as it stands today. It's been standing there now for about 30 years with a repaired head, and up to now no one has chosen to try to again decapitate General Jackson. In the base of this statue, there's a big granite stone at the base of the statue, and under that base is a time capsule with some memorabilia from 1976. And I think that is scheduled to be opened in the year 2076. And I don't guess we'll be around to see that one. But anyway, that's the story of General Andrew Jackson, later to be 7th President of the United States, and how he lost his head in Jackson County, Alabama.